All right, good morning, everyone. We're here at SEPTA's Fort Washington rail station, and today I'm going to be riding into Philadelphia and riding around on SEPTA. This is for a part of a school project I'm doing. I'm going to be surveying Philadelphia's commuter rail system and comparing it to the system we have in Washington, D.C. So I'm going to start here at Fort Washington, get on the train, travel into Center City, go straight through out to Bryn Mawr, Pennsylvania on Amtrak's Keystone Corridor. So I hope you enjoy this video. So this system looks kind of difficult to use. It's going to be tricky to figure out, but thankfully we got 20 minutes till our train arrives.
Yeah.
So it appears the way that one gets a ticket is you have to purchase it on board the train. So it's real different from DC's system, for certain. So it appears that normally during the week, they have a station here that's open and people can purchase tickets at one of these windows, it would appear. But since it's a weekend, closed. It's a Sunday today, so they're closed today. So we'll have to purchase our tickets on board the train. So this is a pretty nice station here. Really different system of purchasing tickets. Should be interesting to purchase tickets on the train. I wonder if that causes delays or anything, or if it causes problems with having to have extra staff and so on. So I wonder why SEPTA has decided to do that instead of, you know, the normal ticket systems that you have trackside. It's kind of strange, unusual for certain.
Plenty of flights like to Europe and stuff, but this is, you know, a flight is canceled. Fortunately, they always.
Or else it's all game stuck there. Europe, right?
Yeah, you're in the airport. But it's, you know, you just always got to be ready.
That's how we are. We're non-revenue.
Yeah.
We got to prepare for something.
Correct. That's what I tell
them. So here's an outbound train headed to Doylestown. So we're on board SEPTA, heading to Center City, Philadelphia, on the Lansdale Doylestown line. So this is really packed for a Sunday, even a lot more people than you'd expect. It's really surprising. So it's very surprising, you know, how many people are on board. It really is a shock. But pretty interesting. Good to see that there's a transit system here that's very well used. So we got our tickets here, headed to Overbrook Station. It's not listed on here, but that's where we're headed. It's Temple University. So what difference does it make? I'm already going to record that.
Different from last. Always, you have to always have an extra mind. the only way.
Ready to drink.
Good luck on your cruise.
Thank you.
Yeah, have a safe trip.
Out of curiosity,
You're making a movie for some purpose.
Yes, sir. Partly for a school project, partly because I just like trains.
What is the school? Oh, here it is. Don't let me disturb you.
Oh, that's right. I'm going to get on this one anyway. Coming into the concourse here of this large station. Wow. Pretty magnificent. The statue. Pretty magnificent, huh?
Very impressive.
So we're outside 30th Street Station here. Gonna transfer over to the subway to go over to the Liberty Bell and Independence Hall. This subway is called the Market-Frankford line, so we're gonna ride that over there. So we're here at 30th Street Subway Station once again. On the outside there are trolley lines, on the inside is a subway line. So we're gonna take the train over to 5th Street to go see the Liberty Bell and all that stuff. So we had to walk outside of 30th Street Station, Amtrak Station, to transfer over here, so that was not a great transfer to transit, but oh well, it'll decrease its connectivity rating. But, so not the greatest transit system outside of commuter rail, not the greatest subway system, it would appear. Hall now. I'm going to go check out the Liberty Bell after riding the Market-Frankford line in from 30th Street to 5th Street. That was a pretty good trip. Pretty crowded on the subway, so it's good to see lots of people using transit. But not an easy transfer from 30th Street Station over to the subway. So that could use some improvement.
Attention.
And there's the Liberty Bell.
The fact that the bell originally hung inside Independence Hall, the place where the American colonies declared independence, and where the United
Tired horse. We're at SEPTA's 11th Street Station, which connects directly to the regional rail station here at Jefferson Station. This is a big improvement over the 30th Street connection. Here it's just a direct connection through this tunnel here over to Jefferson Station. So that's a major improvement over 30th Street. So down there is SEPTA's Jefferson Commuter Rail Station. direct connection from the subway. Very good. On a Sunday afternoon, the train was quite crowded, so we moved towards the back of the train to find a less crowded car.
The first mile, you know, the end is 1,000 miles down there.
Subway station. Pennsylvania Railroad here. Thank you. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe for more great content. Again, thank you for watching, and God bless you.